Hello students, myself Swati Agrawal. Today I am going to teach you a topic in science, that is nutrition in plants. So what is basically under this chapter, we are going to discuss the following topics, that is the nutrition, the basic definition of the nutrition it will cover. Next topic will be different modes of nutrition. Next, the process of the photosynthesis. After that, we will discuss the leaves, that is how the leaves are useful in preparing the food in the process of the photosynthesis. So the photosynthesis and the basic structure of the leaves are interconnected. Next point will be our different modes of nutrition in plants, that is other than the basic nutrition in the plants, what are the other different types of the plants which have the nutrition. And the last but not the least, getting the minerals from the soil, that is how the plants are able to get the extra minerals from the soil. Now here we can see the word nutrition. So how this word is derived? This word is derived from the word nutrients. As in the earlier classes, you have learned the various components of the food, like the fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals, carbohydrates. So all these are the essential nutrients which are required by our body. So the nutrition word is derived from the word nutrients. So now basically, what is the nutrition? It is actually how you take in the food and how you utilize it to gain energy in order to survive and to perform the other activities. So you are taking in the food. So by taking in the food, you are gaining the energy. And the nutrition is the process how you utilize it to gain the energy. So the definition of the nutrition will be a process by which organisms takes in the food and utilize it in order to survive. Now there are main two modes of nutrition. As you can see in the slide, it is autotrophic and the heterotrophic. If we remove the word auto and trophs, so auto means self and trophic means nourishment, that is the organisms which prepare their own food are called the autotrophs, or that process is called the autotrophic. Self-nourishment, that means they are dependent on self for their nourishment to gain the nutrients. So under the autotrophic nutrition, the plants make their own food. So the plants are known as the autotrophs. While on the other side, the word is heterotrophic. If we do the meaning of the hetero and the trophic, so hetero means others and the trophic means as usual nourishment. So that means the organisms which are depend upon the others for their nourishment or for their food to survive, they are called the heterotrophic. So under this category, we have the animals and the human beings. So they are dependent on the others for their nourishment. Now you will ask a question that human beings are making their own food, so why they are considered as the heterotroph? Yes, they can prepare their own food by cooking, and but the raw materials which they are obtaining, they are getting from the plants. Okay, so that's why they are considered to be as the heterotrophic. So they are dependent on the plants indirectly for their survival, for their food. So that's why the human beings are considered as the heterotrophic. Now students, in this slide we are going to study about the process of the photosynthesis. But before learning the process of the photosynthesis, let us consider where does the food prepared in the plants. Yes, it is written clearly, the leaves. Leaves are known as the food factory of the plants. So, all the raw materials which are required in the process of the photosynthesis, it must be reached to the leaves. They are considered as the food factory of the plants. All the food which is prepared by the plants, it is on the leaves only. So, leaves are the main essential part of the photosynthesis. Now let us consider what are the raw materials which are required in the process of the photosynthesis. Here it is the list: water and the mineral. First main essential ingredient is the water and the minerals. So where does we get the water and the minerals? Yes, of course, from the soil. The soil is rich in the water and the minerals. So it is the water and the minerals which are used in the process of the photosynthesis. They are absorbed from the soil. Next essential ingredient is the carbon dioxide. Yes, of course, the carbon dioxide we get it from the air only. The plants get it from the air. But the carbon dioxide, as you can see in the diagram also, it is absorbed by the tiny pores which are present on the surface of the leaves. And these tiny pores are known as the stomata. It is basically a small opening through which the carbon dioxide enters and the oxygen is released. So the stomata is nothing, it is the small opening through which the carbon dioxide enters, and it have the two guard cells in it. Next thing is sunlight. Of course, the sun is the ultimate source of the energy through which we get the sunlight. But in the process of the photosynthesis, there is a green pigment present in the leaf that is called the chlorophyll. Due to the presence of the green plastid, that is known as the chloroplast, the color of the leaves are the green in colors. The sunlight is absorbed by this chlorophyll and then it is synthesized in the process of the photosynthesis. Now we have known that the raw materials which are required in the process of the photosynthesis and how we are getting it. Now the thing is, the green plants take in the carbon dioxide from the air and the water from the soil. Of course, the carbon dioxide is absorbed with the help of the stomata and the water is absorbed by the roots and carried it to the leaves by various channels which are running through the stem, through the root, then stem and to the different branches, and finally it is reaches to the leaves where the process of the photosynthesis takes place. So basically, what is the process of the photosynthesis? It is the process by which the plants make their own food with the help of the water and the carbon dioxide in the presence of the sunlight. Now here it is, the equation is given. After combining of the carbon dioxide and the water in the presence of the sunlight, it gives us the carbohydrates plus oxygen. Carbohydrates can be synthesized as the starch and the food. So whenever you pick up a leaf of any plant and if you break it, the leaf, you will see a white substance, a sticky substance is coming out. What is that? That is only the starch. So with the presence of that sticky white substance, you can easily make out that the process of the photosynthesis takes place and it is stored as the food extra energy or as the extra starch in the manner of the fruits and the vegetables. And during the process of the photosynthesis, you will see the oxygen is released, and this oxygen is the gas which is utilized by the human beings in the process of the respiration.
Now students, in this slide we are going to learn the various modes of the nutrition in the plants. Now in the earlier slides we have learned that the plants are the autotrophs, that is they contain the chlorophyll and the leaves. With the help of that they make their own food. Now what about those plants which do not contain the chlorophyll, which can't make their own food? So in those types of, there are the various types of the plants which cannot make their own food. First one is the insectivorous plants. As the name suggests, insectivorous plants, the plants which depends on the insects for their food and for their nourishment. In this example, we can take the example of the pitcher plant. Pitcher plant, as the name suggests again, that the pitcher means it is a jug type leaves. These plants are containing the jug type leaves with the lid upon it, that is the lid which covers the leaves of the of this plant. So what happens in this types of the plant, the insect comes and in the pitcher they have the hairy substance. When the insect come and sit inside this pitcher plant, the insect get trapped and tangled on the hairs which are present on the pitcher plant, and the moment the insect sit, the lid get closed. So the insect get trapped inside the pitcher plant, and what happened after that, the digestive juice present in the pitcher plant, it get secreted and it absorbs all the nutrients from the insects. So that is how the insectivorous plants have their nourishment. Next is the parasitic plants. In the parasitic plants there are two types, that is the host and the parasitic. The plant which is dependent upon the other plant for their nourishment, that is known as the parasitic, and on which it is dependent, that is called the host. For example, we will take one example, that is cuscuta. This is the cuscuta is a fungus which is, as you can see in the picture, there is a yellow type structure is there over a huge tree. The tree, the main tree is known as the host, and this cuscuta is known as the parasite which is dependent on the main plants because it cannot make its own food, because it doesn't have the chlorophyll, so it cannot make its own food, and that's why it takes the ready-made food from the plant on which it is climbing, and the plant on which it is climbing is called the host. Next type of the mode of the nutrition is the saprotrophs. Saprotrophs are those the organisms which depend upon the dead or the decaying matter for their nutrition. For example, the fungus. You can do one activity in this. Take a bread and moist it, a very lightly moist it with the water, and keep it in the cool place. And after 2-3 days you will see a green like structure is appear on the surface of the bread. So what is that bread? That is the fungus only which takes the nourishment or which takes its nutrients from the decaying matter, that is the bread. So this type of the plants are called as the saprotrophs, or the saprotrophic type of nutrition, in which they take their nutrition from the dead or the decaying matter. Last is the symbiotic relationship. Now what is a symbiotic relationship? In this type of the relationship, two plants, they live together and share and shelter the nutrients, that is they are dependent on each other for their food and for their nourishment. For example, algae and the fungus. Now the algae contains the chlorophyll, but the fungus doesn't contain the chlorophyll. So what happened, due to the presence of the chlorophyll, algae makes the food for the fungus. So fungus is dependent on the algae for the food, and the algae is dependent on the fungus for the shelter, water and the minerals. So fungus suck all the water and the minerals and it passes to the algae, and algae in return prepare the food for the fungus. So these are the interrelated. They both, algae and the fungus, are dependent on each other for their food, for their share of nutrients, and for the shelter.
Hello students, so far we have learned in the previous slide the basic definition of the nutrition, different modes of the nutrition, how plants are able to make their food with the process called the photosynthesis, the basic structure of the leaf, and after that we have learned that the different modes of the nutrition of the plants which do not contain the chlorophyll or which they cannot make their own food. Now in this slide we will learn how the nutrients are replenished in the soil. As far we know that the plants are the autotrophs and they make their own food. And they make their own food with the help of the minerals and the nutrients which are obtained from the soil. But as the time passes, their amount in the soil keeps on declining. So in order to keep the nutrients intact in the soil, what we will do to make the soil enrich with the nutrients? We use the fertilizers and the manures. These fertilizers and the manures are rich in the nutrients like the potassium, phosphorus and the nitrogen, which are keeps on adding to the soil time by time so that the level of the nutrients in the soil should not be declined. Now what happened, these, you have seen the farmers are using the fertilizers and the manures to their crops. So these crops, what happened, they utilize the nitrogen very much, but the amount of the nitrogen which is present in the soil they have used. What about after that? They can't use the atmospheric nitrogen, as we know that the nitrogen is present in the air, but they cannot use that nitrogen directly. These crops or the plants can use the nitrogen in the soluble form, and there is a bacterium which is called the rhizobium and are present in the roots which convert this atmospheric nitrogen into the soluble form, and that is used by the crops or the plants. So that is how we know that how the soil is replenished with the nutrients again time by time. Thank you. I hope you like my slides, and these videos and these slides will help you in your studies. Thank you, students.